So hello friends, now in our previous video of lung pathology we have discussed about cancer in detail. Now in this particular video we are going to start with the pneumoconiosis, clear? So just first take the intro of this disease, or first how we will define this disease. So this is a lung disease which is produced by your organic and inorganic particulates and chemical fumes and vapors. So this is a lung disease produced by organic as well as inorganic as well as chemical fumes and vapors, and this is fibrosing restrictive lung disease. There will be fibrosis, okay? So this is example of fibrosing restrictive lung disease, clear? Now basically this disease develops due to non-neoplastic reaction to mineral dust, that is organic and inorganic or fumes, clear? So let's move to the next part. And it is usually due to occupational exposure. Just taking some examples such as coal workers' pneumoconiosis. It is due to working in coal mines. Silicosis is seen in metal casting work or sand blasting or stone cutters. Then asbestos related diseases, which are seen in persons which are related with mining or installation and removal of insulation. Clear? And the basic pathogenesis behind all of them are a little bit similar, such as start with inhalation of mineral dust particle, clear, and sizes of 1 to 5 micrometer, which are small enough to reach your terminal airways, and they will settle in air sacs, and their alveolar macrophages come and ingest that particular dust or particles, and that will initiate inflammatory reactions and fibrosis. So first inhalation, then ingestion by macrophages, then there will be inflammatory reactions and fibrosis, clear? Now we have to mainly focus on three, and before going to that let's discuss about some more extra points about pathogenesis. Okay, that basically pathogenesis depend on amount of dust which are retained in the lung and airway. It will depend on size, shape of that particular dust. Okay, I have told na, size of 1 to 5 micrometer, which are very small, that are very dangerous. Then it will also depend on the solubility of the solubility and physicochemical reactivity of the particle, clear? Smaller particles which are basically soluble in pulmonary fluid can reach toxic level rapidly, and it will produce an acute lung injury, whereas larger particles which are not soluble, they will persist within the lung parenchyma for many years, clear? And additional risk factor is your other irritants, okay, means such as tobacco smoking and other associated factors. So let's discuss the three main type, that is coal workers pneumoconiosis, silicosis and asbestos related disease. So first just we will look at differences between these three. Okay, so let's start with the basic, that is first, that is coal workers pneumoconiosis. Okay, now location, so it is mainly involved your upper lobe. Silicosis, which is most prevalent, this is the most prevalent pneumoconiosis, that is silicosis. So it will also involve mainly upper lobe, and this asbestos related disease mainly involves your lower lobes. I will come into detail of this all. Now upper lobes, then upper zones of lower lobes are also involved. Hilar lymph nodes are involved, very important point. Hilar lymph node and asbestos related disease have also subpleural locations. So these are the basic involvement of lung, which portion of the lung is involved. Now coming to the pathogenic particles, so here coal particles and carbon pigments. Here your crystalline or amorphous form of silica, clear? And this crystalline is more pathogenic in compared to your amorphous, and most pathogenic is your quartz particles. Here the two forms are available, serpentine and amphibole. Serpentine is more common, but amphibole is more pathogenic. Serpentine is more common, but amphibole is more pathogenic. Then risk of TB, no risk of TB here, but silica makes alveolar macrophages dysfunctional, so there will increase risk of TB. So this is very, very important MCQ question, that silicosis increases the risk of tuberculosis. I will come into detail of that, don't worry. This absent, risk of cancer absent, but present in silicosis as well as asbestos related disease, clear? Then I will come to histopathology later on. First I should discuss about some more point about coal workers pneumoconiosis, clear? Now this coal worker pneumoconiosis, as I have to look where I have given or not histopathology differentiation. Okay, so let's discuss the first, sorry, yes, coal workers pneumoconiosis. So when we talk about the macroscopy, so it is this Kohlberger's pneumoconiosis is divided into two groups. That is pulmonary asymptomatic anthracosis, and the second group, friends, that is simple Kohlberger's pneumoconiosis with little pulmonary dysfunction. And the third one, that is the most severe one, is complicated Kohlberger's pneumoconiosis. Clear? So these are the three categorization. Now coming to the simple Kohlberger's pneumoconiosis, so here you will get Kohl macule and Kohl nodule. Two things you will get here. You will get Kohl macule and you will get Kohl nodule. What are these? I am going to discuss that, don't worry. So Kohl macule and Kohl nodule you are getting here. Kohl macule, what is Kohl macule? So they are basically non-palpable lesion that is about 1 to 2 millimeter in diameter. Okay, 1 to 2 millimeter in diameter palpable lesions, that is known as Kohl macule. Kohl nodule, they are larger but less than 2 centimeter. Okay, means in centimeter means Kohl nodule, in millimeter Kohl macule. Clear? Okay, now in complicated cases there will be fibrosis. Now coming to silicosis, so these are the important points for Kohlberger's pneumoconiosis. No need to worry. Yes, silicosis. Coming to silicosis, so we are knowing it is due to either crystalline form or amorphous form. Crystalline is more pathogenic. The pathogenesis mechanism is same as we have discussed here. This pathogenesis is same for all. So if you will get short notes on silicosis, then write the same pathogenesis as you have written in there. Okay. Now here again, silicosis again divided into simple silicosis, progressive, massive fibrosis. In simple silicosis, you will get again silicotic nodules. I will discuss later on the microscopy of this. Silicotic nodules you will get. Okay. Then hilar lymph nodes also enlarge, and on X-ray that give you egg cell calcification. This is an important MCQ question. Hilar lymph node lymphadenopathy, and that will give you that will basically give you egg cell calcification like appearance. That is very important. Clear? Now coming to the asbestos related disease, I will discuss later on, don't worry. So first come to the histopathology. So Kohlberger's pneumoconiosis, so there will be anthracosis, means inhaled carbon pigment ingested by alveolar macrophages. Clear? This is known as anthracosis, and it also seen in tobacco smokers and urban dwellers. Then you will also get carbon laden macrophages. I was talking about Kohl macule, and that will collect to form Kohl nodule. Kohl macule was of millimeter size and Kohl nodule is of centimeter size. Then you will get progressive massive fibrosis, the same which we have discussed here. In silicosis, you will get collagenous silicotic nodules. Here see, this is the silica particles. Okay, and it is look like a whirlpool of pink. See, this will be your antigen at the center, silicotic nodules, antigen at the center, and which is surrounded by basically like this, there will be surrounding collagen. Okay, and there, and after collagen you will get certain lymphocyte cell, there will be lymphocyte. Okay, lymphocyte will be present. Then after this there will be fibroblast cell. Okay, there will, you will get certain fibroblast cell. Clear? Okay, so this is the basic structure of silicotic nodule. Then there will be massive fibrosis will be there. Then there will be lymph node involvement. I have told you that is hilar lymph node, and on radiology you will see egg cell calcification. So this is very important MCQ question. Now asbestos related disease, so here you will see asbestos particle which are coated with proteins and ferritin. Clear? And this is, and this even combined with hemosiderin, this will stain, means pearl stain will get positive. Okay, when you will do pearl staining here. Clear? This is nucleus and this is asbestos body here shown in golden brown color. Clear? Okay, means on microscopy in asbestos related disease you will get two or three bodies. The first is your asbestos body. Okay, and then disease name asbestosis, so asbestos body you will see. What is asbestos body? So they consist of basically asbestos fiber which are coated with protein and iron. Clear? Here that we are talking about, that was asbestos bodies. Clear? And the appearance of asbestos body is very important. This is dumbbell shape appearance. Asbestos body will give dumbbell shape appearance. The second body which you will get here is ferruginous bodies. The second body which you will get here is ferruginous body. Clear? Okay, now some more point which are related to asbestosis. So here I have written list of asbestos related diseases. What are the diseases which are associated with your asbestos? So the first is your pleural plaque, which is the most common manifestation. Then pleural effusion can occur. Then parenchymal interstitial fibrosis can occur, that is asbestosis. Lung carcinoma can occur, and most common type is adenocarcinoma and mesothelioma. That is the most specific cancer which are associated with asbestos. This mesothelioma is most specific cancer that is associated with your asbestos. So remember these five clinical diseases which are associated with your asbestos. Now, one more point: asbestos is of two types, as I have described, serpentine form, and the second one is your amphibole form. One example of serpentine form that is important for your examination: chrysolite. And amphibole form is, just remember, crocidolite. Okay, crocidolite and hemosite. Crocidolite and hemosite. The serpentine, the name itself indicating that they are long, curly, flexible structure, and they are more soluble than amphibole. Whereas amphibole is straight, rigid, okay, and they are more pathogenic. So this is about this. And now, how asbestosis can lead to cancer? So it can form your reactive free radicals and toxic chemicals, that is leading to this cancer. Okay, and on gross, how the lung will be seen in asbestosis? So honeycombing appearance is seen. Honeycombing appearance is seen. Clear? So these are the important points about your pneumoconiosis. So thank you for watching. Best of luck. In next video, we will discuss about the next part, that will be acute respiratory distress. Thank you.